speakers of the day, past chairman, sponsors, representatives, invitees from other professional bodies, invited guests, professional colleagues, committee members at ICAI ABU DHABI Chapter, ladies and gentlemen, good morning everyone. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to the PDC event on artificial intelligence and blockchain. Since the beginning of the modern times, each industrial revolution was driven by different automation. While factory machines and fossil fuel drove the previous industrial revolution, but the ongoing automation revolution is based on data-driven artificial intelligence. Accounting has not seen much innovation since the creation of double entry bookkeeping. As companies are going forward to fully automate using the AI-based technologies, there will be huge opportunities and serious challenges which will disrupt the accounting industry. Technologies like blockchain, artificial intelligence, Internet of Things is going to change the role of accountants and the way we are going to do the work. Are we prepared to embrace the changes and win it? Today we have three sessions. First session on artificial intelligence by Mr. ANURAAG GUGLAANI from Ayurveda Group. Second session on future of accounting by Anshul Srivastava from Union Insurance. And the last session on blockchain by Karthikeya Bhargava from PLMP Blockchain. Now some administrative instructions. Hope the members of the chapter present have signed at the registration desk. If not, kindly sign up after the event so that CP credit can be applied. Kindly switch off your mobile phones or put them on silent mode for better listening. Now I call upon our chapter chairman, C. Ashish Pandari, for his chairman address. Thank you.
Thank you very much, John. Speakers of the day, Dr. ANURAAG GUGLAANI, Mr. Anshul Srivastava, Mr. Karthikeyan Bhargava, past chairman, sponsors, representatives, fellow members, my team at ICAI ABU DHABI Chapter, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It's indeed a very great pleasure to see you, such a large number of members attending on a weekend morning. So this clearly illustrates that the topic is really very interesting, and we all are looking forward to make lots of ideas from the speeches of the learned speakers. A calculator is a tool for humans to do math more quickly and accurately than they could ever do by hand. Similarly, AI computers are tools for us to perform tasks too difficult or too expensive for us to do on our own, such as analyzing large data sets, or keeping up to data on medical research. AI will impact every industry on Earth, including manufacturing, agriculture, healthcare, and more. The sad thing about artificial intelligence is that it lacks artifice and therefore intelligence. By far, the greatest danger of artificial intelligence is that people know that they conclude poorly that they understand it. So to overcome this danger, let's hear from our experts and to know more about these upcoming technologies. And what more than to hear directly from the experts? If a blockchain technology isn't just a more efficiency way to settle securities, it will fundamentally change market structure because the settlement risk will be reduced to minimum. There is an opportunity to recreate the financial world as we know it in the parallel universe. That is the blockchain. We are writing rules for this whole new universe. Let's learn how we can develop our knowledge on this amazing technology which will revolutionize entire marketplace. Now something on chapter front. We are planning to conduct a one-day workshop on Power BI. The details will be communicated to you soon. the batch would be between 20 to 25 members, and it will cost around 250 to 300 dirhams. And we'll be sending the details on the WhatsApp. It will be done on a weekend, maybe on 28th and 29th. We'll be doing depending on the members' response. The chapter is organizing live telecast. You have all received the communication on the live telecast of India Park matches and all Indian matches at ISC. It's on the big screen. So I request all the members to come with their families to enjoy the match and see India winning. Chapter is also taking members to Russia. There are two departure dates, first on 5th of July and next is on 8th of July. 5th of July is totally booked, 50 members will be leaving on 5th of July. There are around 10 seats left for the 8th of July, so I request members to come up and grab those seats. It's at an amazing price on full board basis. The best part is that if you respond early, we are planning to arrange your documents submitted to Russian Embassy. On our own end, we will go in one go with all the members who then submit their applications by tomorrow. The chapter is also planning to celebrate CA Day along with Year of Governance. We have an amazing lineup of speakers, and the details will be shared with you soon on WhatsApp and other modes of communication. I would also like to take this opportunity to request you to please share contact details about the prospective sponsors and speakers for our annual seminar, which is scheduled for 7th and 8th of November, and your kind help will be really appreciated. And I would like to thank all the speakers who take time out of their busy schedule and to share the experience with our members. Thank you very much. I would like to request CA Priyanka to take all the proceedings from here. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you all had a nice breakfast and all set to absorb the technical sessions ahead. The rapid advancement in technology is not only benefiting our lives on one hand, but on the other hand, it also poses a challenge for us to keep ourselves updated. Artificial intelligence is everywhere, and the best part with AI is its ability to quickly learn, which means it is a challenge for us also to be updated and abreast with all this new technology. Our first session is going to be on artificial intelligence, robotics process automation. And we are very pleased to have a learned authority on the subject matter, Dr. ANURAAG GUGLAANI. Dr. ANURAAG GUGLAANI is a partner at Mayur Batra Group, heading the verticals of strategy, transformation, globalization, and technology advisory. He's very highly networked. He's a renowned speaker at retail forums and investment business and startup summits. He's based in Middle East region for over two decades and has worked extensively all over the world, heading large family business groups in several diversified industries. He's highly connected globally with decision makers in government and private sectors. He also plays a major role as an active investor in startups, having managed all the verticals of organization's core and support functions, including finance, internal audit, HR, quality, supply chain, service, marketing, sales, and business development. He's been instrumental in profit enhancement, operational and digital transformation, and diversification of the organizations. He's a graduate of the prestigious National Defense Academy. He did his MBA in finance and marketing from Symbiosis, EMB in organization leadership from IMD Switzerland, and PhD in entrepreneurship. Please join me in welcoming Dr. ANURAAG for our first session.
Recently, the Minister of Artificial Intelligence, Mr. Omar Al-Ulama, a brilliant gentleman, 29 years old, but when you talk to him, you would realize that you are way behind technology. Also, some statistics for you to absorb. Artificial intelligence, I'll read some statistics which I got from the minister himself. Artificial intelligence is going to have a $122 billion impact on UAE GDP. And it is going to grow the UAE's economy by $96 billion. UAE aims at becoming the world's number one player in artificial intelligence by 2031. So we are sitting in a country which is going to dominate artificial intelligence, and if we don't know about it, or if we are not a part of it, then our future is a little bit bleak. And not only this, also globally, AI is going to have an impact of $1.2 trillion, and by 2035, it is going to double the economic growth of the world. So that's why I say that it is a pretty wise decision that you are there. So whatever we can contribute and talk about a little bit, and thanks to Ashish, Neeraj, Rohit and everybody else who have decided to hold a session on these topics today. Hopefully we exchange some knowledge and learn something back from you. I would like to do just a quick knowledge check here so that what I'm talking about makes relevant sense. If you could raise your hand and tell me how many of you work in organizations where you have an exposure to robotic process automation or that is already being used in your organizations, if you would let me know. Okay, so that's just three or four. Okay, and how many of you have some detailed insight about intelligent automation, robotic process automation? Okay. So which means, and if as you saw in my profile, I am not a technical person per se, right? I am a business doctor, and my emphasis has been on single point, which is enhancing profitability of organizations, and rest everything is a tool to achieve that, right? Which includes digital transformation, cost reduction, or whatever it may be. So that's the subject which we are going to talk about today. And because all of you are a part of Chartered Accountant Association, so you are a chartered accountant yourself, you are from the finance sector, so we are going to touch on the impact of RPA and AI, Robotic Process Automation, Artificial Intelligence, on the finance leaders. Couple of things that we would cover today: introduction to Robotic Process Automation and AI. I will use the short form, the RPA and AI. Impact of RPA and AI on the finance leaders. The CFO's vision of the future by imbibing these technologies. A few case studies where actually RPA has been implemented and what did it deliver. Lessons learned from the client experiences where these technologies have been applied. And I would request all of you to hold on your questions till the end, because there is a lot of material in this presentation, and if all of nothing of that gets covered what is in your mind, then we would open up the question and answer session at the end of the presentation. Okay, so in simple language, robotic process automation is the use of a software robot. We all see robots in fancy movies and we know what those things physically look like, but robotic process automation is all about software robots called softbots, which is primarily a program. And that program, what does it do? What you and I sit and do in a digital world on a daily basis, this is exactly what is mimicked by a software bot. It mimics the actions that we do, and while interacting with the UI, the user interface level of a computer system, right? Like when we log into the morning, we come and do a couple of things, that's exactly what a software bot does. It mimics our activities and does it and transform them, deliver their job. Now, how is it different from conventional automation? For sure, because we as human beings have limited data processing capability and limited storage capability. So that is not a problem for the bots. That's why they are able to do things much more quicker. And because this technology has been around for quite some time now globally, it is now extremely, extremely cheap to deploy this technology, and it can be deployed fairly quickly. It is relatively less intrusive because it is not an ERP, you are not coding, you are not using the APIs. It's a simple program which is written, and because it works at the user level, so it is lesser intrusive than a conventional automation system. And the beauty of it is that while it sounds very techy and fancy, it does not require highly skilled process experts to manage this going forward in organization. So dependability, obviously, depending upon who is the implementation partner, but generally an approach that we take is that the dependability on the implementation partner is reduced, and everything can be done in-house going forward. And unlike any other automation, because we said this is at the user interface level, so anything which the bot does is clearly visible on the screen. You can monitor it any given point of time. You see how it acts and performs. Some of the key characteristics: highly reliable. It operates 365 days a year. Does not call in the morning a WhatsApp message saying I'm sick today, my child is sick, I cannot attend. It does not have those limitations. It works 365 days a year without any complaints, full time available. Highly accurate because it's trained to give the right decisions. It follows the steps or the protocol given to it. It does not think beyond that. It sees no need to think as to why I should not do it or do it, so it operates and brings you accurate results. Productivity, it frees up at least 25-30% of time at the least for human beings to utilize their time to make more valuable decisions. It's a boon for auditors because anything that it does, it leaves a trail and it can easily be seen, and the whole steps can be monitored and seen what did it do and why it didn't work if it didn't. Highly scalable, you can ramp it up and down because we all know that in our businesses there are several seasonalities where things go up and down, but if you keep that kind of manpower strength throughout the year, it's highly expensive. So you can scale it up and down as you want based on the demand in organizations. And we, especially men, are supposed to be very poor at multitasking. At least our wives tell us that. The bots don't have that problem. Bots can do multitasking. In the morning they can do finance function, in the afternoon they can do HR, they can do IT in the evening, and you can program them whatever to do in the night, and by the time you come next day morning, it has everything ready for you. It can be trained on multiple things and multiple users, which again is not possible for one human being to adopt. Okay, so now how it sounds fancy, how does it work? Simply, RPA uses the software to execute the business processes in a repetitive, audited, and controlled manner. It is an orchestrator. It is actually using legacy applications for transaction processing, data manipulation, response gathering, triggering, and communication. So basically, it is working with multiple legacy systems. So it does not require a new system to be added in the organization. Whatever you work on, whether it is Oracle, Excel, Tally, Sage, SAP, it does not matter. Just like you and I can work on that system and operate, a bot can also do the same thing. And it does all this with very limited human participation. Actually, there are two kinds of automation. One is an attended automation and an unattended automation. Unattended is where everything from A to Z is managed by the bot itself, and it does not require any human intervention. However, in an attended automation, about 80% of the work would be done by the bot and deliver something, so the 20% would be for subjective judgment of a human being to add that value and then take that forward. Now, how can RPA be integrated alongside? Because one of the main things which comes out of this is, if all this is what a bot can do, then what are we going to do? And that's a very valid question, because statistics say 1.8 billion jobs will be eliminated. 1.8 billion jobs will be eliminated because of artificial intelligence. And as in the introduction somebody said, there is going to be a lot of impact on certain industries, finance being one. However, the good news is that at the same time, there are 2.3 billion new jobs which AI will create, which means that there is a net increase of almost about 500 million new jobs. But what is it going to require? It is going to require acquisition of new skills. Just like before computers came, we used to have manual account ledgers. Then we had to learn Excel. Then we had to learn ERP. Otherwise, we were outdated. Similarly, and what we are talking about now, AI and RPA, which is already in action, we will have to learn those skills, acquire those skills, if we want to contribute to that growth and be a part of that growth in the future. So robots will deliver. What will happen is that the bots will deliver the repetitive, voluminous, mundane tasks, which in any case does not add any value to our own this. If as chartered accountants or as data experts, we are all day sitting and just extracting information from multiple systems, collating and producing a report, we are not adding anything to the knowledge. So this task is primarily what the bots would do, while human beings will work on building relationships, which bots can't do, provide the subjective judgment, deliver low frequency exception tasks, and manage the change and improvement. And also, another interesting aspect here is that we have all been trained, we have gone through several programs on how to manage people. And we all, as managers, as we grow up, we are told to learn management skills. However, in the future, the skills required to be learned are how to manage machines and not human beings any longer, because machines are going to do all that repetitive task, right? So even on relationship building, things are going to change how you look at it in the future. So soft skills, technical skills, everything would need a makeover. Key benefits of RPA. First, very, very important, a robot is 1/10 the cost of an in-house full-time equivalent in any organization. 1/10 the cost of a full-time equivalent. However, if that job is currently outsourced, then it works out to 1/3 of the cost of an outsourced. So this is all about, we've seen outsourcing is a big industry. However, once RPA gets implemented, outsourcing is reduced. You get the jobs back into the organization because you do not need it any longer. You shifted them out because of reason not being able to manage them or being more costly. The whole scenario changes when a bot is put into place. So, as I said, unattended automated solution that works 24/7 without complaints. Double-digit reduction in error rates. Robots never forget their training. You define SOP for a bot, it follows that process. If there's an exception, it throws the exception onto you. You tell the bot how to manage that exception, it becomes a process for it, it learns, and machines are smart, they learn with every transaction, and which is why they don't forget the training. And at any point of time, they are not influenced by whether I have not paid my credit card bill, my loan payment is due, my child is sick, all that does not matter. And this is very important because this impacts the delivery of accuracy report which the bots can do. RPA works in existing IT landscape. Like I said, you don't have to do any major IT changes in your organization. Robots can be trained by existing business users. So you and I, whosoever is the actual user, can eventually train the robot. That's why I said it does not require highly skilled business process experts. And obviously, speed and accuracy, because of the speed at which it can process data, improves significantly. So principally saying, just in a nutshell, RPA executes processes as human beings do, but at significantly lower cost. So what are typically the kinds of processes which are ideally suitable for an RPA implementation? Any rule-based transaction where the rules are clearly defined, processes that involve clear and unambiguous rules robots can follow, is a perfect fit for where a bot can be deployed. Electronic data. The data has to be electronic. As long as the robot can read that input data, process it, store the result electronically, it is an extremely good fit. Processes that can be broken down into series of orchestrated repeatable activities. Similarly, as we say, every process has an SOP. For example, if we have to make tea in the morning, right, it's a process, right? You have to boil the water, you have to add tea leaves to it, you have to add milk to it, you pour it off, so it's a four-step process. So similarly, any process in an organization is defined into those SOPs, programmed through the bot, which is a clean sheet of paper, you write the program on it, and that becomes the workflow, very easy for the bot to follow. What is a boon? The next two are something which bots love to do, which we human beings actually hate. Anything high volume task, invoice reconciliations, execution of data sets for order processing. Also, where humans actually end up making a lot of errors, which requires rework to be done, all these bots can manage seamlessly without an issue. And one of the other major benefit of RPA is that it can use multiple systems at the same time. You come into the morning, you are logging into an SAP, you are using an Excel, you are opening an email, your MS Office, you are using third-party data, you are going onto the web, anything and everything that you do multiple, what can do simultaneously and collate everything and produce something which you would like to see. And the opportunity of the cost of reworking and all that obviously also drives down the cost in any organization. Also, the automation spectrum is constantly innovating. You have robotic process automation, as we just said, which is basically rule-based. It can use structured data at user interface level. You see something there called the screen mirroring. Screen mirroring is like what I do on a screen that is mimicked by the bot, and it starts doing it, which is a relatively easy technology. However, there are several processes which require a more intelligent automation to be put into place where you have unstructured data. Unstructured data means, for example, you have several suppliers with different kinds of invoice patterns, and so the logo could be placed somewhere, the description could be somewhere. So, and that's where you have to put an intelligent automation which can use NLP, natural language processing technology, and capability to make that unstructured data structured and then put it up for processing. Now, since I've spoken a little bit and probably hopefully created some interest, I would like to play one video of a bot in action. It's a process which most of you should relate to, a vendor reconciliation process. This was quite a voluminous task for an organization, and you can actually see in this how a human being did that act, how a bot ended up doing it, and what was the derivative of it.
Welcome to Minefields. We are a vendor agnostic advisory firm. The objective of this video is to demonstrate how a human action can be mimicked by a robotic software. In this video, we have demonstrated human interaction between two different IT systems being now executed by robot. The current as-is vendor reconciliation process is summarized as follows. 1. The vendor sends out the statements via email in PDF or Excel format to the offshore team, wherein they extract the necessary data, invoice number, invoice date, and invoice amount from these statements and copy it to a macro-based Excel. 2. The offshore resource then logs into SAP and queries on the vendor, extracts all the outstanding invoices against the vendor in a temporary Excel, and copies the necessary data to the macro-based Excel. 3. The output of the macro-based Excel are the unmatched invoices, if any, between the vendor statement and the SAP data. 4. If there are any unmatched invoices, they are further looked up in Vendor Invoice Management, VIM. If there still exists any unmatched invoices, the unmatched list is sent to the vendor, asking him for a copy or details of the same. If there are no unmatched invoices, the statement is sent further to the respective team for processing. Currently, the whole process takes about 40 minutes per reconciliation. The proposed automated vendor reconciliation process follows the same steps in the exact same sequence end to end, but without any human intervention, and takes only about 2 to 4 minutes per reconciliation. In this video, we are tasking vendor statement with more than 100 invoices. The robot software here is programmed to read a designated mailbox and search for unread emails with the subject recon. These emails contain vendor statement in PDF and or Excel format. The robot is scheduled to run at 6 a.m. every morning. The steps it performs is as follows. Reads the unread email with the subject recon. Download the attachment or vendor statement. Here, the vendor statement is in Excel format. Opens the Excel file and now copies specific data to the macro-based Excel. Once the data is copied to macro-based Excel, it logs into SAP using the login ID and password allocated to it, enters the transaction code, queries by the vendor number, generates a list of all the outstanding invoices for the vendor, downloads it into a temporary Excel and copies specific data, invoice number, invoice date, and invoice amount to the macro-based Excel, runs the macro. The output of the macro are the unmatched invoices, if any, between the vendor statement and SAP data. If there are no unmatched invoices, then the process ends here. The vendor statements are sent further to the respective team for payment processing. However, in our scenario, we have some unmatched invoices. The robot will now try to find these unmatched invoices by logging into VIM. If these invoices are found in VIM, it will extract the data into a temporary Excel sheet, copy it again to the macro, and run the macro again. In our test case scenario, the invoices were not found in VIM. Hence, a discrepancy exists here. The unmatched invoice numbers via automated email are sent to the vendor, keeping in CC the AP team asking for a duplicate copy of the invoice. The robot now searches the mailbox and reads the next unread email. The next email contains the vendor statement in a PDF format. The robot converts the PDF to text first and then to a CSV file. The robot then copies specific data, invoice number, invoice date, and invoice amount from the CSV file to the macro file, logs into SAP using the login ID and password allocated to it, and performs the same steps. Attached is a screenshot of the email the robot sends out. Automation of the whole process has brought direct monetary benefit of close to $180,000 year on year. The current manual process, which was offshored earlier, has been brought back, which resulted in redeployment of 6 FTE offshore and 0.5 FTE onshore. The unrealized benefits included reduced average handling time from 40 minutes to 1 minute, ability of client to scale up from 200 vendor reconciliation with yearly frequency to all 4,000 plus vendors on monthly frequency, resulting in increased process efficiency, reduced error rates, and better realization from vendors. Minefields, grow for welcome to mine.
So, before everybody goes in sleep mode. So this is by far the most easiest of the process which a bot can manage. Very quick to deploy, 2 to 3 weeks time, and this can bot can learn this and do, because it's just interacting. It has a couple of steps which are there. Right. So this is just to give you an example. Bot can send out a mail. Bot can go into multiple systems to read an email, send out an email, do all the.